Welcome to a brief discussion on using progress monitoring to ensure that math instruction builds on what each child knows, taken from the IES practice guide, Teaching Math to Young Children. Let's get started. There are 5 recommendations in the practice guide, and all are based on a systematic review of research conducted by researchers and practitioners with expertise and experience in early math development. In this video, we will discuss recommendation 3, which discusses the importance of progress monitoring to effectively target instruction to a child's individual developmental level. So, what do we mean by progress monitoring? To effectively instruct students and support them in moving to the next step in the math progression, teachers must know what knowledge and skills children already possess. Progress monitoring is important for identifying where children are along a progression of levels of thinking and learning in a given math topic to adapt instruction to target each child's development. When progress monitoring is combined with information on children's developmental progressions, as introduced in recommendations 1 and 2 in the practice guide, teachers can more effectively target instruction to support children's math development. This combination creates a complete learning trajectory, including a goal, a developmental progression of levels of thinking, and instruction fine-tuned to each level. The first way to carry out recommendation 3 is to determine each child's existing math knowledge using introductory activities, observations, and assessments. Introductory activities provide teachers the opportunity to assess a child's understanding of a new concept and what they can do independently. For example, at the beginning of the year, inviting each small group of children to play with instructional manipulatives, such as a rich set of shapes or counters, achieves multiple goals. To our point, discussion with children quickly reveals what they know about shapes and their names, and about their spontaneous interest in the use of numbers. Children might subitize or quickly recognize and name groups of manipulatives, or count groups, just to see how many. Simultaneously, children become familiar with the manipulatives, and such play actually empowers them to better solve problems with these objects later. Finally, once they have played with manipulatives, children are ready to use them to face challenges and solve problems with them. Through observation, teachers can watch the way children solve a problem or task to learn what children know. In addition to observing, teachers can ask children questions as they work on a task to get them to describe their problem-solving processes aloud. For example, if children were asked, "Please get enough pencils for everybody at your table?" Teachers can see if some children pick up a random number of pencils, but can pass them out accurately, or if they count the children at the table and get exactly that number, or if they use other strategies. Formal assessments, such as standardized tests administered throughout the year, can be useful to identify learning goals if teachers receive performance feedback on children from these assessments. For example, a beginning of the year assessment may show that a class of children already recognizes many shapes, indicating that teachers can start building on this knowledge instead of wasting precious time teaching something children already know. The second way to carry out recommendation 3 is to tailor instruction to each child's needs and relate new ideas to his or her existing knowledge. Teachers can use the information they learn from observation and assessment of a child's skills to then design tailored activities. This then is using learning trajectories. That is, teachers determine the level of thinking along the developmental progression and then use instruction, environment, tasks, activities, and teaching strategies selected to help children learn the next level. For more information, including research on learning trajectories, see learningtrajectories.org. When tailoring activities, it is important that they are not too difficult and frustrating for a child. Activities should focus on the level just above the child's current level of thinking on the math developmental progressions. For example, if a child can count verbally, but not yet count objects accurately, engage in activities that naturally promote keeping one-to-one correspondence when counting, such as slow, rhythmic counting, while clapping or using a counting wand to count children in a group. It is also important to connect new learning with children's existing understanding and interests. For example, if children are already interested in and know how to play a board game such as Candyland, you can introduce new learning by switching the often provided drawing cards that show the next color to move forward to drawing cards or a die that shows a number. Small group activities provide good opportunities to tailor instruction to each child's developmental levels. Whether it's an altered Candyland or any other fun racing game, remember to adjust the numbers to the child's level. For example, use a wooden cube to make your own die with only 1, 2, 3 on the 6 faces. The third way to carry out recommendation 3 is to assess, record, and monitor each child's progress so that instructional goals and methods can be adjusted as needed. It's important to continue the flow of progress monitoring on an ongoing basis. The best way to do this is to integrate it fully into the regular day using curriculum-embedded assessment, including informal observations of children at learning centers, or records of children's work during intentional activities. For example, teachers can use checklists or other forms to keep track of their observations. Checklists are helpful when trying to quickly observe and note what each child in a class can and cannot do when performing a specific task or activity. The record or checklist helps teachers assess each child's progress more easily on a skill over time. For further information related to teaching math to young children, please take some time to review the full practice guide. Also, visit the REL Central website for more education research and resources to support schools and student outcomes.